Hello students, today we will commence our class with writing skill. Writing skill comes in section B. The very first question of writing skill comes for 4 marks. It comprises notice writing, advertisement writing, poster making and invitation and their replies. So the very first thing we are taking over here is notice writing for 4 marks. The very first thing we will see, what is the format of the notice writing. It's very important students to keep this format of notice writing all the time quite ready in your mind, so you will not miss anything. Second thing, whatever things are there in format, it must be particularly in the same way it must lay in your notebook. The very first thing will write name of the organization or institute or office. Then after this we write notice, N-O-T-I-C-E, this word we write notice in capital letters. Then we write date. When we write date, we will not write D-A-T-E, date again. For format we do tell students that date comes over here on left hand side after notice on left hand side. Date comes before heading, but this date must not be dated over here like D-A-T-E and then here, no, directly 20th April, 2020, in such way. Then comes heading. Catchy heading or subject should be there. Whatever we are writing, we are going to write in the notice, this subject or heading must be according to that and it must be catchy. It must be very catchy and very creative. So you can pick a few words that can be a soul of this body of the notice or heading. This, it's better if you write in capital and underline that. To underline the heading is not in the format, but if you underline the heading, it will be catchy, it will be very attractive and presentation will be better. So after subject or after heading, what to be written? It will be content or body of the notice. What will come in content or body of the notice? We are supposed to answer 5 W's over there. What are 5 W's over here? The very first thing is what, that what we are going to speak to. Why the reason, where, place, when, time, who, or whom. For whom it is going to be and who is putting the notice. So they all things will come over here in the content or body of the notice. It varies because it's for event. We do write in such way. Sometimes it's not event, sometimes through notice we do put up some information. That may be. This place will not be there, time will not be there. But whatever details will be there, for whom it is written and who is telling all the details comes over here. So these 5 W's should be answered over there. Various kinds of notices we do write. It can be written for information or any event or any program. It can be written for lost property or found property. So for various reasons, we do write notice and proper format is required to write notice. What is next in the format is signature. Whose signature? Signature or the person issuing the notice. After signature, name in block letters. So it will be clear that who has put the notice, what's the name of the person. Because signature, it's not always that signature can be read by everyone. Then designation of the person. Designation means post. Post of the person who is issuing the notice. Okay, these are very important points, and the most important is box. We are supposed to draw box after writing our notice. We are supposed to put our notice into a box. Box is compulsory, otherwise marks can be deducted. Do not repeat your points. Usually this is found when students do write the content or the body of the notice. They keep on repeating and lines the same thing. So be particular in your language, very simple, lucid language to be written over there very clearly. These are these 5 W's, what, why, where, when, who or whom should be answered properly over here. After drafting your notice, you can read your notice from this point of view, so it will be clear that whether you answered all these W's over there or not. Always read your notice as a reader, so you easily come to know that particular thing is missing. Okay, and this is a format. Next, we'll take an example to make it more clear with you. And you're supposed to write the format in your notebook. Don't forget to write the entire format. What your writing skill will do, the very first thing, you will write the format in your notebook, and then we'll do any example that we'll do, and whatever homework will be given, that also you will carry on in your notebooks, whatever available with you. Thank you.